Hi guys, it's Igor, and today our review is about 2016 Honda HR-V. In this review, we will talk as usual of technical spec. We will talk about interior, exterior, how good this car looks under the knees, how they protect this car from rust, how reliable this car. As usual, we will show how car looks underneath, on top, inside, and we will tell about our opinion and we compare this car with any other competitors. The second generation of Honda HR-V appeared on the US market in 2015. On the US market, we have only one choice with the engine. 1.8 liter engine with 141 horsepower. If you check any car magazine data, you will find out that Honda HR-V is one of the slowest car in the class. From 0 to 60, Honda HR-V can make in 9.6 seconds. And this was one of the most powerful engines, which is you can find it on HR-V with 1.8 liter. On the Europe market, it's 1.5 liter engine with 135 horsepower. Could you imagine how slow this car on the Europe market? But my opinion is that the best engine for this car would be the same as they install on Asian market with 1.5 liter turbocharger and 181 horsepower. But the biggest achievements for Honda HR-V, it is not its dynamics characteristic, but it is cargo volume and interior volume. For 2019 and later model, you have only one option for Honda HR-V, that's CVT transmission. For early model as this one, you can choose between 6-speed manual transmission and CVT transmission. For 2019, they did some slightly redesign with new bumper, new moldings, and also they improved headlights. Right now you have options like fully LED headlights with like LED panel over here, the same as Acura MDX, or just with LED beam with lens for like cheaper version. On older version you have only options with halogen, but at least you have fog light, which you're not gonna have on Toyota CHR. Where I think I find out during preparation for this review, I would say any car reviewer tells that Mazda CX-3 is more sportier car compared to Honda HR-V or anybody in this class. But numbers tell completely different, and the same story was with our previous review about 2018 Toyota RAV4. For example, if you have good handling, this means that your car is supposed to have good lateral acceleration. And for example, Honda HR-V has 0.88G during the turn. And everybody understands that Mazda CX-3 is a very sporty car, but Mazda CX-3 has just 0.84, which is much smaller number. And the Honda HR-V has much better number, which is weird, right? Which is mean if you're gonna put some good experienced driver on a hand to handle this car, they're gonna show much better track result with Honda HR-V than Mazda CX-3. The same story with the brake. For example, if you wanna stop your car, Honda HR-V from 60 miles per hour to zero, you're gonna need just 114 feet. But if you wanna do the same with Mazda CX-3, which is lighter car, you need 118 feet. Weird. Who is faster and who is more sporty, Mazda or Honda? The ground clearance for Honda HR-V, it is not too big. It's just 6.7 inches and mostly because of this reinforcement for fuel tank. Plus 17 inch low profile tires is not the best options to go off-road. The most noticeable stuff outside the Honda HR-V is it's a rear door handle, which is, I would say, looks stylish, but not really comfortable. I really like this kind of design of keyless entry to the car because they build this with sensor for the handle to open the door. You don't have to press anything, just put your hands here during coronavirus, very nice. And to close, you need to press just regular button, much better than any sensor because usually it's much harder to do. With the button, you really good understand what you did. I decided to check before this review what other people think about Honda HR-V. And one of the biggest amount of complaints about driver's seat. Most of the people think that they are very uncomfortable, but my opinion is a little bit different, which is kind of understandable because car is small and you're not gonna expect wide seats over here. With my weight, which is 185 pounds, I think this car seat is perfect. My opinion is that the seat is very supportive, they hold my body very well, especially this very nice side support that feel more like on sport kind of car seats. And for example, we just recently filmed our previous review, which was 2011 Toyota Highlander, and seats was very wide, and during this some turn I supposed to push my knee inside the door to hold myself in the seats. With this kind of seats everything is perfect. Only one bad thing which I can tell about the seats, it may be a little bit too annoying back support, and very bad that you cannot adjust this back support on a 2016 Honda HR-V. For 2018 redesigned version, they start to put for top of the line version power adjustable seats with a adjustable back support, but if you don't have it during the long trip, it's a little bit annoying. I think for city drive the seat is perfect, especially if you are a skinny person, but if you are a big guy, I think you need something bigger. For long trip, no matter if it's because of the seats or because of the suspension or many other things, I would not recommend it to use Honda HR-V. My height is 6.1, and I believe if you're gonna be like more higher person than me, you're not gonna be sit comfortable in this seat, because my seat move all the way back, all the way down, and the steering wheel always all the way out. If you're gonna be like more bigger or more taller person, I believe you need to choose also another car. I don't like tinted windows on the front driver and front passenger seats, but I think for Honda HR-V it almost must have stuff, because your interior mirror has automatic dimming function, but for outside mirrors you don't have this option. And if you drive this car during the night time somewhere on highway, it really make you blind through the outdoor mirrors. And also I hate this stuff with the Honda. They try to kind of increase safety with this angle the same as on Toyota Venza or any other stuff, but I would say that they make vision through this mirror is more blurry and more scared. In general, I really like quality for all materials inside the Honda HR-V. I would say compared to Toyota Venza or Honda Pilot, it look more expensive. But some design decision, I think it's horrible. If you check any car review or, for example, any car magazine, they tell that this decision to put a shifter on the top and all USB ports and shelf on the bottom is not really comfortable idea. Guys, I would tell my opinion. It's the same comfortable as clean your butt with pants on. For example, it's hard to see something on this shelf during the daytime, but during nighttime I was unable, even with some small light on the bottom, to find it any USB port. And all this wiring which you want to put for to charge your phone or, for example, napkins, it's unreal to see. It's really horrible idea. I really want to take some saw and cut this out, and I don't know, put some buttons on the top of the dashboard with your gears, and that's it. If you will put something like your phone, your bottle, or anything in this cup holder, you have two options if you decide to move your armrest. Or you're gonna break your phone, or you're gonna break your armrest. Of course, most of the time you would have something over here like your phone or your bottle, and you're gonna move your armrest all the way to the back. And in this case, it's very uncomfortable. You see, I have pretty long arms, but as you can see, I cannot reach this armrest if I am not gonna move it. And even like this, it's not really comfortable position. I think HR-V is not the best choice for ladies, especially for ladies who like to have with them some cosmetics, some like nice bottle with a coffee inside the interior, cell phones, because it's not so many space and pockets inside the interior. Cup holder is stupid, this shelf is useless, and even armrest, you see, that's all what we can fit. They're just our tester for noise level. Only one good thing is about glove box, but again, it's not much. I believe any normal people carry inside the car much more stuff. In general, design of dashboard I really like, but I hate that because they put everything is touchscreen. First of all, touchscreen, look, we just start our car and look how slow it is. It's still try to load all his software, but again, like, don't worry, we will come back at the end of our review, it will be fine. First of all, let's talk about climate control. Oh, finally something happened. Yeah, finally. First of all, I hate it because it's touchscreen. You cannot understand what you press if you're not gonna move your eye from your road to climate control, because it's not intuitive as on regular car with regular hard buttons, all these touchscreen buttons, you're really supposed to watch what you press it. Also, it's single zone climate control, and they put for some reason everything on the left side, and when you drive the car you close all the stuff with steering wheel and with your hand, you don't see anything. Always to check what's going on in your climate control to understand what you need to press, you're supposed to move your hand from your steering wheel, of course, because you need to press, and then watch what you are doing, and really watch, not just press it. And also, If you decide to put at least something over here, like your phone, what's happening with him anytime, to for example, put some navigation over here if you don't have any handle, or for example, if you borrow this car with somebody else, you always, even with the wiring charge, with charging wire, you can touch something and then you see it's turning on. With hard button, it's not gonna happen. Also, a lot of people complain about how this car gets warmer or colder inside the interior. I would say maybe it's a true, because during the hot weather I drove this car in Boston, and I think AC start to work very, very slow. And the same with the heat. Right now it's a little bit colder weather, and I believe if heating system will work more faster. I don't want to tell anything bad about this heating or AC system. Better put in your comments to this review what you think about. But I think maybe, yes, it's possible that it's a little bit slow with the heating, and the same with AC condition. Nice feature that the Honda HR-V has electric power emergency brake, and also this button, which is brake hold, which allow you to, for example, use your brake without pressing your brake. For example, it's very convenient if you're stuck somewhere in the traffic. You just press this button, and this button hold, I mean, your car hold your brakes without brake pedal. Navigation system and audio system design very bad, also work very slow, and they put Apple CarPlay and Android system, I think, only in 2019. For 2016, you don't have these options, and you see how everything slow. We have top of the line version with the sunroof, but weird that this car doesn't have any sunglass holder, which means that if you're gonna put your sunglass in cup holder also, well, one more place, right, where to put stuff, you're gonna crash this again with this armrest. If you need to turn lights on the back seat, only one option how you can do this, it's move your hand over here and move this button. You cannot do this as on any other normal car with some button on the center console. The dashboard easy to read, everything understandable, but only one complaint that they didn't put a temperature gauge for your coolant system. Also, this ring around your speedometer changed his color from green to white depending how you drive your car. If you drive with a like low usage of fuel, it's turned to green. If you drive too fast, it's turned to white, which just means that if you like green color, better drive your car slowly. For this kind of class, Honda HR-V has a lot of space for back passengers, especially for rear leg. You see, even behind myself, my height is 6.1 feet, I still have at least 1 inch between my knees and front seats. The leg room for Honda HR-V is 39.1 inch. It's a little bit smaller in Jeep Renegade, around 1 inch, but if you think about rear seat passengers, for this kind of class, don't even think about Mazda CX-3. You can fit, for example, people as a person as me on the back seat only if you cut his legs. The back seat is fine. It's, oh, again, like only people complain about height for back passenger, but again, like I'm a pretty tall guy, 6'1", and I still have at least 1 inch on top of me, but it's only for two passenger. If I'm gonna sit on the middle seat, yes, I'm gonna touch the roof, but again, like not so many people use this car for long trip for three passengers. But bad thing about Honda HR-V, because they don't have any armrest and also just one cup holder and no any USB ports, just one power outlet over here. Good thing that you can adjust position of your back on Honda HR-V with two positions. This right now is more reclined, and this one is more straight. But if you don't care about the legroom on the back seat and care more about how many car seats you can put on the back, I think the best options would be Jeep Renegade, because Jeep Renegade a little bit wider, if I could remember, around 2 inches. But Honda HR-V also a pretty good choice, because compared to Mazda CX-3 or Nissan Juke, it's really normal back seats over here on Honda HR-V. I believe a lot of people choose this car because they're living in the city, because it's easy to park, because car is small, and also if you are living in the city, for some people it's kind of normal routine to bring your clothes to laundromat, and HR-V in this case is also one of the best options. You see, two basket for your laundry fits here very easy. You can put even one on top of another, and I believe if you're gonna move like this, you can put at least some more stuff which you're not gonna do in any other SUV in this class. With back seats on position, a Honda HR-V has 24.3 cubic feet of cargo volume. The closest comparative Jeep Renegade don't have even the same amount, just 18 cubic feet. And if you wanna increase your cargo space, you can fold your back seats and make the seats completely flat and put much more stuff. If you unfold your back seats, you have 58.8 cubic feet. Jeep Renegade has just 51. But for example, if you're a young family just with two person, you and your wife, and you decide to go somewhere outside and do some biking, Honda HR-V, I think it's only one car in the class who allow you to bring some carry-on stuff with you and also a couple bikes. And all of this thanks to Honda's Magic Seat. It's the same design as on Honda Fit and Honda Ridgeline. You can put your seats like this position and you can easily fit over here a couple bikes. Also, the same kind of seats allow you to put more stuff underneath of the seats. At least you can put a couple backpack, I believe like three or even four underneath of the car. And in this case, nobody can beat this Honda. If you have jet ski and if you want to bring it to ocean, best options would be Jeep Renegade. The towing capacity for Jeep Renegade is 2000 pounds. For Honda HR-V, just 1100. I would say about reliability of Honda HR-V is no complaint online, and I don't have any complaint from my customer. But only one thing which I found it online that was about transmission. All review which I found it online was that sometimes this car has like jerky, and also they find it in oil pan some pieces of metal inside this transmission, and most of the time it's happened around 60,000 miles. We will see what's happened with this car, because this car has just 56,000 miles, but I hope it's gonna be the same as with any other our customer with Honda Fit or Honda HR-V. Some of them have even 160 miles, and I would say no issue with engine and transmission. Okay, we're under the hood of 2016 Honda HR-V. What I can tell? Not much, to be honest, because as we understand, we're on the United States market and we are not really happy with the small cars, because we have big family, we have like far away our grocery stores, and we need big car with big engine. So this one is more like a city style car, and because of this car has small and easy to maintain engine. On United States market, they install only 1.8 liter engine, which is good because it's one of the most powerful engine for this car, because even this car engine, I would say, not too powerful, just 141 horsepower. But on the Europe market, the same car with 131 horsepower. Also, you can buy hybrid, which is good, which we don't have it. And on Asian market, I think they have a kind of Type S model or SI, like we have in the United States. Actually, it's the same engine, 1.5 liter with turbo. And in this case, around 200 horsepower. And in this case, it's much more fun to drive car. I cannot tell you much about reliability of Honda HR-V, because it's pretty new cars and not many problems with them. And to be honest, again, it's not so popular. And most of the time I have deal with the Honda Fit, which is also not like crazy popular car. But again, like 1.8 liter engine, the same as it was installed on 2012 Civic, but more modern generation. Very reliable, easy to maintain. Spark plugs, which you're supposed to replace on 100,000 miles. Easy to reach. Maybe, I don't know, your mechanic, if it's honest mechanic, will charge you something like for 30 minute job, no more than 45, which is could be like 50, 60 bucks just for labor. And each spark plug would be $16. Which is not gonna make any like huge difference in your budget, I believe, if you're gonna do this in 100,000 miles. No more power steering, it's electric power steering on this car, which is again less maintenance and more space under the hood, as you can see. Air filter with regular clips, easy to maintain, much easier compared to Honda Fit. You can do easy in your garage. Oxygen sensor on the top of the engine. Everything is easy. It looks like this car was built to like be ready to replace your engine even in your garage. We don't have many customers with Honda HR-V. That's why I decide to check what other people tell online about this car. And a lot of people complain mostly about transmission and mostly about quality of parts which was built in Mexico. And as I can see, even radiator built in Mexico, with my experience for Ford parts from Mexico, it's horrible quality. But with Honda, I would say I don't see any difference between Japanese-built Hondas and the Mexican-built Hondas. But some owners tell that, oh, my previous Honda was built in Japan and was much, much better. I don't know. I cannot tell this. As a mechanic, for me, they all look the same. Also, if you have to replace alternator, it's easy. You see, again, you can do this in your garage or pay to your mechanic again, not the crazy money. I would say maybe hour and a half labor, not more, because it's on the top radiator. Also not a big job, even if you have to replace after accident. Only one bad thing about HRV, because they have small style of Honda's battery. And most of this battery, even if they not original, for example, from AutoZone or from Pep Boys, usually cost around $200. And I cannot tell that they live forever. Usually they 3-5 years maximum and you have to replace. For example, for big style Honda's batteries, they usually at least 5 years old, could be before replacement. I wish if Honda would be the same under the knees, we will check this, but for example, under the hood, as you can see, at least they put some sealant on the welding spot and looks like this is gonna protect this car more from rust. Nice that Honda starts to build its new generation on Honda HR-V with the more durable steel, which is increased safety of this car, and also this car right now more easy to maintain and maintain and fix. You see right now you can replace if you cannot reach something under the hood from under the fender. You see right now this is just noise insulation or mud shield, but with this car I would say it's not a big deal. I believe you can reach everything from the hood, but for German's car, for example, for some BMW more complicated car, it's really huge achievement, because for some parts without the stuff you can't even reach it. You really need to replace your mud shield or fender liner to reach some parts. Okay, let's check how 2016 Honda HR-V look under the knees. First thing which we can see over here is that car absolutely naked under the knees, which is a good, which means that you can reach everything. But definitely don't use this car for off-roading. I understand that it's mostly city car, but maybe somebody think if you have all-wheel drive, you can do everything. But as you can see, so empty over here, and subframe just protect your engine over here on the back. I would say it's not even an engine, just your part of your transmission, just rear end. Because front end of the transmission and whole engine is completely open. If something happened and you really decide to go off-road on this car, I would suggest you to put some thick metal protection underneath of your engine, because in other case you're definitely gonna crash your oil pan for engine or oil pan for transmission. And this may be a reason why Honda installed not shitty Nissan or Mazda steel oil pan. They put really nice hard aluminum oil pans, which again very durable and has much better anti-rust protection compared to regular steel, which usually on Mazda and the Nissan get rusty for 2016 completely. Sometimes you even have leaked through these oil pans. Little bit about difference between German's car and, for example, Japanese's Honda. For example, let's see how they build most of the stuff. You see, for Honda, they use more metal stuff. For example, let's check this cover. I believe it's thermostat over here. Mostly on Europe brand, they build it from plastic. As you can see, underneath of Honda HR-V, most of the part built from metal. That's the reason why Japanese brand has much less oil leak and especially coolant leaks. Because most of the time, European brand get overheated and all this plastic, especially in Volkswagen, get cracked and you get huge amount of coolant leak. And that's the reason why you see so many advertisement on Craigslist or any other advertisement website, when you see overheated BMW, overheated Volkswagen, Audi, or anything like this. AC compressor also very easy to reach, but what really made me, I don't know, maybe even a little bit scared, the size of this compressor. Yes, I understand this car is small, engine is small, everything is small, but I found a lot of complaint online that this car get
warm and cold during hot weather very slowly. And maybe that's the reason of because of the size of this AC compressor. I cannot tell you exactly my opinion, but yesterday when during my city driving, I think yes, it was car get cold a little bit slow, but again, like I need a little bit more time to prove my opinion. And the same story today about during the cold weather driving. I think during my drive from like around 20 miles to my garage, I think other car get warmer a little bit faster. Maybe they didn't like build well, or not even build, like design well, heating and cooling system of this car. But again, like if somebody have his opinion, please share with us in your comments. Car is 2016 with 56,000 of miles, and you see it look great, mostly because this car parked in garage. For 2016, usually most of the Hondas looks worse. Honda does good job. They seal a lot of welding spot and connection spot, but again, like, it's not even close to European brand. The European brand has much more plastic shield. And what's the difference right now? I find out with the, for example, Volkswagen and the any Japanese brand, any even top of the line like Lexus, that how bad Japanese car anti-rust protection. I always told during our review that Honda and Toyota has the best anti-rust protection compared to any other Japanese brands, especially compared to another Asian build the market as a Korean. Korean cars is horrible with anti-rust coating. But just recently I get here for oil change couple Mexican built Jettas, which is they call, I believe, Jetta City. This Jetta with old style 2.0 liter engine, which they built in Mexico with a horrible plastic inside the interior, with a no plastic shield under the car. And this Volkswagen doesn't look like Volkswagen anymore. It looked more like, I don't know, like cheap version of Mitsubishi. But what I found out on this Volkswagen, even cheap Mexican built Volkswagen has much better anti-rust protection compared to top of the line Lexus. Because for example, on Lexus, you would never find any anti-rust coating inside the frame. On Volkswagen, on the cheap one, they spray anti-rust substantial inside the frame, and that's the reason why any German's brand much better if you want to keep this car forever. Yes, they're going to cost you more to maintain and to repair, but if you have, for example, a lot of money, or if you are living in some country with a cheaper price for labor, I would say maybe German's car is better. Because with German's quality of metal, it cars would last forever. But you're supposed to understand that another stuff, like cheap plastic under the hood on Germans, need to replace more often. That's, you're supposed to always calculate which is what is better, Japanese or Germans in your area. A lot of people joke about position of fuel tank on Honda HR-V and the same on Honda Fit, because fuel tank located directly under your front driver and front passenger seats. That's why I would say not a really good car to smoke inside. Because of the flat floor inside the Honda HR-V, they put everything lower, and the same happened with your fuel tank. That's why they put this funny look protection for your fuel tank, and the same steel protection on the middle. But looks weird because they didn't put anything over here. Maybe they think that they you could destroy in somehow if your drive shaft will fall off your fuel tank with the drive shaft, but they don't care about this area. Because of flat floor inside the Honda HR-V, they put a lot of stuff very low, and especially fuel tank. I think it's the most lowest part of your vehicle. That's why they have to put this protection for fuel tank. And one of them over here, steel plate, another one is here. And it looks like they think that maybe in case if you're gonna fall off your drive shaft, they put steel protection even inside. Very simple design of rear suspension without any stabilizer links or stabilizer bars allow you to replace your rear differential very easy, or even service this differential. I believe you can replace this differential even by yourself in your regular garage, even without the lift. As you can see, Honda HR-V right now has electric power emergency brake, which means that right now it's more complicated to replace brake pads if you want to do this by yourself. Of course, you can replace this motor and push a piston in this case much easier, like by yourself, or you need special software or special computer which allow you to move this electronically this piston inside the brake caliper. For 2016, Honda HR-V has the biggest size of the wheels, which is 17 inch. On 2019 Honda HR-V Sport, they replaced it with 18 inch rims. And funny thing that for sport version, they put even wider and little bit taller tires. For example, on 2016 CR-V and even now they use, CR-V, HR-V, they use 2015 55 17 tires. On sport version, they use 225 50 18, which is taller and wider tires. I think this wheel looks too wide for this tire, and I would suggest if you use this car in the city and do a lot of scratch on the rim as over here, use a little bit wider tires, for example as 235 50 17. But if you want to save some money on the gas, or if you want a nice set of winter tires, maybe it would be nice to install 225 60 17 tires for winter time. Guys, maybe sometime you wonder why your mechanic charge you a lot of money for some easy job, for example as a replacement of exhaust system, and on this Honda I will tell you why. For example, this Honda is 2016 and most of the Hondas on exhaust system has 40 millimeters nuts. You see, like 40 millimeters fit very easy, but it's just 2016, mostly garage kept car, and right now I can put even 13 millimeter key on it. It's a little bit rusty, but really, believe me, I will do it, especially if I need to unscrew it. And you see how rusty they are. This behind of our operator, 2008 Acura MDX. And for 2008 Acura MDX, the same nuts already 11 millimeters, and unscrew them was unreal. I had to use the torch, and that's the reason. Because your nuts on, no, not your nuts, your car nuts on the exhaust system get smaller, get much rustier on Japanese brand, and you need to use torch, which is again like more money spending to unscrew this. That's the reason why sometimes your mechanic charge you more. Not because it's hard labor, because he's supposed to use totally different tools, and for some cars it's not more 1 hour labor as they put in any maintenance recommendation for the car. It's sometimes it's even like could be like 3 or 4 hours if you want to save everything as it's supposed to be from manufacturer, not destroy, not just cut it these nuts. And this Honda is a good example of bad quality of metal, especially on a exhaust system of any Japanese brand. For example, behind me, 2005 Jaguar Super V8, which is my car, and I just did some work on exhaust, and any nuts which was screwed to exhaust manifold to exhaust system is 30 millimeter from manufacturing, and this 2005 car with 150,000 miles on it and still the same 30 millimeter. It's like example for you how good quality on German car of the metal and how bad on Japanese. In general, pipes on Japanese brand is good, but usually hardware is horrible. And as I told you, on Japanese brand as Nissan, even flange is horrible cheap metal.
Complain online also about suspension on this car. A lot of people tell it's too hard and too solid, and even one of our customers who has exactly the same car as we're driving right now tells that each time when you drive this car and get some small stone on the road or even some small bump, you feel like somebody put nail in your ass. I would say I really can confirm this suspension is very solid, but that's why you have so good handling. And also I believe if you're gonna put more high profile tires, it's gonna be softer, but again handling in this case would be worse. Another complaint about noise level inside this interior of Honda HR-V, I would say I don't feel anything like uncomfortable for me, but I think only one way why people told about it, that because with this CVT transmission and small power from engine, each time when you press acceleration, you really hurt this engine. But if you're driving this car in the city, it's absolutely fine. Again, this car was built, I believe, for city, not for highway, and in city, and this car is absolutely perfect. And I believe who has this car in the city gonna tell this is a great car. who use this car for a long highway trip, I think they're gonna tell this car is horrible. Usability is great in this car. Really, you can see everything, like windshield is very close to you and the window is big. I don't have any problem. I don't really like this idea to install the camera inside the right mirror for Honda HR-V. They think that they're gonna skip installation of blind spot monitors for 2016. For 2019, they start to do all normal stuff as blind spot monitors, as a line keep assistant, emergency braking, and all other electronic stuff which right now has any other normal car. But why I don't like this camera, because for daytime it's fine when you see something in this screen on center of your dashboard, but for nighttime it's so blurry and I would say it's useless. And also, if you watch in this screen during your night driving, but even during the daytime, you really need to move your eye from a road to your screen, and it's pretty long distance from your eye. Much better to check your blind spot just to watch in your right mirror than to your screen. That's why I'd say, if you really want to keep safe your driving and have like safer driving, I would say don't use this. I mean, like, don't really watch in the screen, better watch in your mirror. It's nice to have, but not really help. The car equipped with CVT transmission and have all these like pedals to switch the gears on this car is absolutely useless. Only one good reason to have them, I believe, if you want to use your engine to as a brake system, not in any other case. As a summary, buy or not Honda HR-V, depending what you need. If you really have problem with the tiny space on your parking lot, maybe it's a good option, because it's a small car, but with good cargo volume. But if you need comfortable car, think twice, because suspension is pretty solid and you're not going to be comfortable, especially if your baby sleep on a back seat. I would say it's not going to be normal for his dream. He's going to wake up on each bump on the road. If you like to carry more stuff in your car, especially for driver and from passenger, also Honda HR-V not the best option. Also, if you think about top of the line Honda HR-V, I think maybe you need to think a little bit more about Honda CR-V. Yes, it's a little bit bigger car, not so comfortable during the city driving, but if you're gonna go somewhere outside, somewhere for country road, CR-V is definitely much better options. And for example, if you don't have like a couple thousand of dollars more to pay for Honda CR-V, I would just buy Honda CR-V, but maybe 1 or 2 years old, and just if you're scared about this old car, just add to your payment extended warranty. For you, for example, from my experience, I pay for extended warranty just $30 per month, but you don't care about anything. Thank you so much for watching us, and please don't forget to subscribe to our channel.